always gotta start first.
See, yeah. Okay, it's like.
Oh my God.
Oh my bad, you were doing already. It wasn't as great as it was in our heads.
Yeah. Sounds a bit dead.
Today's, yeah. It's bringing up with us.
Bloody idiots, get out of my
face. I don't know what to say.
Okay. Well, why do I always have to go first?
No, wait a minute,
Okay. What it do, baby? It's your girl, Kel Aubrey.
It's Martin Royalty.
And we are back with another episode.
Yes, 162, I believe.
Yes. No, 161.
Just funny, because I was trying to scroll from my Spotify quickly.
I was going to be like, yes.
Yeah, 161.
Yeah, okay. I'm on the ball. But we have a really, really special guest.
A top babe.
Us. Literally.
A top babe.
We're going to get into your skin, by the way, because...
Listen!
Girl.
That's
what you eat fruit.
I'll let you introduce yourself first.
Yes, yes. It's your girl, Nadia Rose. Nastiest Rose. Squad boss. Bob Marley. Yes. Freedom fighter. Big,
love
big
it.
Detector. Click drencher. You know
whoa,
this.
Whoa. I love that.
You're my favorite guest already.
I don't think we've had anyone... And no shade to our previous guests, but...
Of course not.
I don't think we've had anyone with... Like such vim.
Like who sat in the intro.
Yeah, like I love it.
Absolutely love it.
I enter the place. That's how I enter the room.
I absolutely love it. Thank you. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
We really appreciate it. We feel very special because you know you've been a bit, you know, you've been on a little hiatus.
Yeah.
I have.
So we feel very, very privileged. So we had to get the video cameras out.
Honest.
So people know that we're not joking. Like she's really.
You know what? It's so true because we don't usually do visuals.
No, we actually don't.
But really? I was like, we have to.
We have to. So because you're special to us, babes.
Thank you.
But first of all, like when I saw you, I thought skin. Like skin, top notch. Because we've spoken about skin before.
Yeah.
And I've spoken about how like I feel like second puberty hits when you get to a certain age and like your skin is going through it. And I was like, damn, you have really good skin.
Oh, thank you.
Like,
thank
do you have pores? Like, ever had a spot?
No, literally.
Do you know what? I don't know. My mum, I would say it's my mum. Sorry, if my dad's listening. My mum, for me, her skin has just always been incredible. And
that's so nice.
So now she's in her 50s and she looks 20.
Oh, wow.
You know, it's crazy. So yeah, I have to. Had to thank her and my pops.
Yeah, of course, of course. I hope the brands are seeing this.
Right. In here. Give you a skincare
deal. We need a Nadia 15 kind of coat, something. Work
thank
with us.
You.
No, honestly, beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Appreciate
How are you though?
I'm good, you know. I'm good. Feeling like you said, I've been on a hiatus.
Mm-hmm.
And it just kind of feels nice to just be, you know, I'm poking just my peeping, head out.
Yeah.
I'm ready to, you know, to come and just
I think it's the right time as well. Because it's like, cause I feel like if you're on a hiatus, right? I don't think winter's ever the time to make a comeback because it's cold. Yeah. It's just not.
Giving, I agree.
Right.
I agree.
So I think summer is the perfect time.
Oh, yeah.
And the kind of songs that you make as well like, is the perfect time. And I think you've come as well ahead of summer. Because I think sometimes people come back or like, even if it's like you haven't released music in a while or whatever it is, people kind of release music in like July. So no. Lead up to it. Take us there. So by the time it's August, we all know the words. Like, we're all like, On codes.
I agree.
That's it. You get it. Yeah, that's what I'm on. And I'm a summer baby, so
it's your birthday?
June 11th. I'm a Gemini, everyone's favourite.
Not everyone's favourite.
I don't even know this. I don't know who. I just know people don't like Scorpios. Is Scorpios?
Okay, don't do that. And I'm Scorpio.
Who is the toxic one? Everyone's always like, they are not.
So yeah, Scorpios definitely gay. Gemini is 100% gay.
Really?
What about 100%? Cancers?
They hate us. They're like, oh, your teeth haste and young.
Oh, wow. Oh. I think cancers as well, they get it, I think.
No, I think cancers are meant to be like overly emotional.
Yeah, they are.
Really?
They're like crabs, I think.
Yeah,
like I thought I was
Leos. Babies. No, Leos are...
We've all been crying.
Leos are like mama. You like it or you love them or you don't.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
I hope you guys love me. Okay, makes sense.
Yeah, no, I love it because I feel like you said, summertime is like when everyone's in good spirits, like everyone wants to have fun. So it's a good time to come back and drop music and stuff.
100%.
But before we get into the music and everything, we like to do like icebreakers and stuff,
right?
Just to warm us up, you know? So yeah, this is a question of would you rather?
Ooh,
so
okay,
the first one is, would you rather always be 20 minutes early or always be 10 minutes late?
Oh, I'm going to go 20 minutes early.
Yeah, because you was really punctual today.
Guys, listeners and watchers, case in point.
Yeah.
Because she was early today.
I was shocked.
Like, you know, 12 o'clock.
I've got to tell you the truth. Yeah. My punctuality has never been a strong point for me.
Really?
Like, no, honestly, it hasn't. But my new management, they do this thing. They tell me a time, there's like an hour before the real thing.
That's good.
Just to give room, because everything happens when it doesn't need to happen.
Yeah.
So what time did they tell you today?
What'd you say?
What time?
Tell me 11 today, and I got here.
And you got here at 12?
No, I got here 11:38.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a whole hour early.
Yeah.
But then if it was 11, it should have been 38 minutes late.
True,
So do you know what? Pick up the management.
So management have got the right idea. But yeah, I think generally I would like to be early.
Yeah. Do you know, it's all about intention.
There's but too
you
know much what, anxiety bro? With being late.
Yeah. Oh. And you know what? It's just things are not meant to happen are going to happen.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, like, everyone is just slow. I don't know. Yeah. Like, life is, it's like the world knows you're trying to get somewhere.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it's like, what? Let's see. Red light, learner. Yes.
Block road. Oh.
It's a lot. But you know what, though? You're walking in that spirit.
Exactly.
Because if anyone asks us about Nadia, it's like, she's early.
Right. Yeah. If you didn't say she's how early. You're trying to be early,
yeah,
I would have never known, because you was literally on time today.
Honestly.
I should have kept quiet, you know?
Yeah.
You
should have people would have never
you
known.
You should have leaned into it. But like, honestly, we love it.
Mm.
Cool. So the next one is, live in Europe or live in America? This is an interesting one, you know?
I know. Which one is the lesser of the two evils?
After yesterday. Who even knows?
I don't know. I feel like I might have to say the USA. Because like the kind of music I make and the kind of environment
I had a feeling you would say that. Yeah.
Yeah. For me, musically in my career, I feel like that's a nice space. But,
okay, so next one. Never use your phone again or never use social media again.
Ooh.
Social media.
I don't like social media.
Everyone always says that. They're like, but yeah, so great on it. But I feel like social media is a blessing and a curse.
Yeah, yeah, I agree.
It's true. 100%
pros to it. But the cons is just too much.
I feel like
there's a lot of pressure for people. And I feel like if that pressure was alleviated, the world would be a better place. For sure.
I strongly agree with that. Yeah. I feel like there's more cons than pros, I reckon.
Mm-hmm.
And I think a lot of the cons as well, they're not cons that's like easy to shake off. It's not stuff that's like, no, just don't do this. It's cons that's within us that we haven't even realize within us. So it's a place.
Yeah. And it's getting worse, I think. Like, some people think it's good because it's like it's a good way to market yourself and everything. But I feel like there's some aspects of it that is getting like a little bit worse. And
do you know what someone said the other day? It's definitely worse.
Yeah.
Because someone said, so when you post a picture, if you get 100 likes, you think that you're thinking that is so low. But imagine on a normal day you're walking on the streets, 100 people compliment you.
Yeah.
But I had the 50th person thinking, okay, I get it. Message received.
Yeah.
It's so true.
And I've turned off my, hide the like count.
Okay. Because
I feel like it gives me so much anxiety. Like, where I feel like other people are comparing, like, likes.
Okay.
My likes to theirs. I don't know. Mm-hmm. So it's like, I've turned it off. I'm just like, it's none of your business.
Just as others and stuff. Okay.
Yeah.
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 That's interesting.
Okay, next one is discover the cure of a disease or discover life in a new planet.
Oh.
Ooh. You and you're thinking back.
Right?
That's quite philosophical.
Yeah.
Wait now. Right. Cure a current disease.
It just says discover the cure of a disease. So it could be.
Okay.
Yeah.
Discover the cure of a disease.
Let's go current.
Yeah.
Let's go current.
Cure a current disease or what?
Or discover life in a new planet.
Damn. Do you know what? I think I'm gonna cure the fuckery. Like, but can I swear on this?
Yeah, you're free. Do whatever you want to do.
I'm gonna cure the fuckery for sure.
Yeah.
Because I think, it's better to deal with what's happening
now.
Yeah. We're going to discover now and then there's more disease to deal with over there.
I was going to say that. Because when you discover a new place,
you don't know what's waiting for you.
Exactly. You're now in charge of navigating that space. That's a lot.
Yeah, it's true. Okay. Giving up TV for a month or giving up music for a month?
TV.
Mm. Yeah, that's quite easy.
Yeah, if you said music, your label would have come in like, what?
Yeah, no, 100% TV. I don't really watch TV these days, to be honest with you.
Does anyone really? I feel like men watch TV more than women do, you know?
But I miss watching TV.
Sorry, let me just shut that door. It's Brent gone.
I miss watching TV though, because I feel like I'm always on my phone.
Fair, but hold on, is that TV like actually looking at the TV box, or if you're on your laptop watching iPlayer, does that count?
No, I think that actually sitting down in your sofa watching TV, I feel like we don't do that no more.
We don't.
We actually don't. It's always like laptop, iPad, like something that's on the go, but we don't actually sit down and watch TV.
I think men have more TVs than women.
Oh, because of football.
I'm drawing the stats out of nowhere, so please don't quote me your essays. But yeah, because of like games and stuff like that. Because women, we just watch it on laptop.
Yeah. Okay, last one. Lose your sense of taste or lose your sense of smell. This is kind of giving COVID.
Yeah.
I'm gonna lose smell.
I love food.
Can you imagine not tasting? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
I'm gonna lose the smell.
And you're traveling to places you can't taste the food. Damn, that's a waste of a trip.
Yeah, that's
really smell. Cool. Yeah. That's the end of the icebreaker.
That was nice. Wait, did you create those?
No, I didn't.
You found him.
Yeah.
You guys are really sure your essays. You guys are just confessing. You have to work. Confessing.
I always say you have to work smart, not hard.
Yeah, you're right, girl. Yeah,
I'm trying to live in that bag. I haven't navigated it yet. But I'm really trying to live in the bag. But yeah, so we mentioned earlier about, you know, you've been on a hiatus.
Yeah.
What kind of inspired that?
What was the reason?
Do
you know what? So obviously we came out of the pandemic. But yeah, the height of that was, you know, coming towards the end.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know, I just felt like it was an eye opener. Like having that time away from things just opened my eyes to a lot of things. And I established that I needed to just step away for a second. I felt like I was getting a bit lost in things. Like I say, social media, the kind of people I had around me.
Okay.
It just, things just weren't right. I felt like I need a whole just cleanse and detox from everything and everyone. Even like the music I was creating, I love creating music.
Yeah.
But as artists, we do have to take accountability sometimes and say, do you know what? That wasn't my best work. That wasn't, you know, that wasn't my best, you know.
Self-awareness.
Have to.
We love that.
I felt like, I had moments like that and I was just like, right, I just need to take away everything else and just focus. So I just took the time away. I was in the studio all the time. So it was a hiatus from the world.
The world.
Work was still having to run because that's what I know.
Yeah.
I wouldn't know what else to do. So I just got into this space and it was great. I fell in love. I got new management, just everything. And I dashed away all the fake friends and all the nonsense that was there. And I could start to see that it was reflecting in what I was creating, which just felt great. It just encouraged me to keep doing it. Now I'm in a space where I've created a lot of great music. My environment feels right. I feel like I'm in a safe space. I'm just ready to unleash now.
Feels like a spiritual cleanse.
Yeah.
Tell me about
that.
Sometimes we think that we have to work on ourselves on what people can just see on the outside. But then it's like you can work on yourself on the outside, but then your inside is going through it even worse, right? So that sounds so healthy.
Yeah.
That sounds so healthy to me. I really like that.
I think everyone should do it. Absolutely. Once in a while, for sure.
And I love that as well, because I feel like, you know how you mentioned you went on a hiatus, but you said you was working and stuff. But a lot of people think that if it's not out there for them to see, you're not doing nothing. Oh, so people will be thinking you're just sitting in your bed, watching the days go by when it's just like, I'm actually working on myself, but you just don't see it.
I was going to ask you that actually, because before you went on hiatus, did you ever feel like pressure of like comparing yourself to other people and now watching other people? Because how did you navigate knowing that you're working? Because I'm sure you had people be like, oh, like new music. So like, how did you create a healthy thing where it's like, I know what I'm doing. That's all that matters. I'm not going to be watching anyone else.
Do you know what? One of my, like, my things that I live by is don't watch no face. But like I said, when social media and all of this is there, sometimes it was difficult. I'm thinking, no, my motto is don't watch no face, but I would catch myself
watching
face. So I'm like, nah, that doesn't feel right to me. But it happens naturally. Like, you know, it will happen. But I think, it was just a thing of having to identify that it wasn't healthy.
Yeah.
And I needed to step away from that, you know.
Yeah. So do you think, because I know you mentioned as well about, because we gave the choice of obviously the UK and America. And I've always wanted to know, like, what are people's thoughts? Musicians' thoughts on like the UK scene, because I feel like it's very different to the American scene. So do you feel like it's like they're more accepting of like female rappers or like mm-hmm. musicians in general? Or is it just a thing of just like, yeah, we're just kind of making it up in our heads?
I think, I mean, especially for my genre, you know, the rap hip hop world.
Yeah.
US, you know, that's where it began. So I think they are always going to be more just accepting two dope hip hop artists. It's just, and yeah, it's massive over there.
Yeah.
And I think over here, you know, we're always like, UK's bad vibes. And I wouldn't say UK is bad vibes. Mm. I just feel like UK can be bad vibes.
I think they're bad vibes. I think.
Serious. Nah, because I've had great moments. I've had great moments in the UK and I've witnessed great moments in the UK. But there is definitely a lot of just, it doesn't even make sense sometimes. You'll see the things that are said or the way things are reacted to. You're just like, why even? Yeah. Like, why is that in your heart? I don't,
I think with the UK, I think they're very quick to lift you up and give you all the praises. Yeah. But I think the one moment you slip up.
Oh, yeah, they're ready to
throw Dungeon like, Dragon. Like,
not Dungeon Dragon.
Everybody's like, it's just, it's a lot. So I feel like, that's why for me, I feel like the UK is bad vibes. Yeah, because I just think sometimes we don't really act as a community as much as we think we are. Sometimes we don't.
But in the same breath, when the UK is ready to back someone,
do be back.
Yeah, exactly, back, exactly.
But I guess maybe it's few and far between.
So if given the opportunity, would you like relocate?
Do you know what? I wanted to. That was my plan this year, actually. Really? Mid hiatus.
You're gonna leave us.
I had this moment. It was like, I don't know, I had this moment. And I was like, I've gotta go. Like to LA. Wow. That was my I saw it all. I just saw it all. And I started talking to people I know over there and you know, making arrangements.
Oh wow.
It was deep. I was really
I'm out of here.
Going. And then, obviously, a girl is not double jabbed.
Oh, yes. All that stuff.
That kind of first banner in the works.
Because we've had a lot of UK talent moving across the borders.
And I don't blame them. Because you know what's funny? I was listening to, because Chris Brown's got a new album. And I love my
You have to mention
I will work Chris Brown and Nicki Minaj into any conversation. Just try me. Vegetables, I can work it in somehow. But so I heard LMA on it. And like, I was just like, because I like her, I listen to her and everything. And I thought she was really good as an artist. And I was like, damn, like she actually,
she was
really left.
She's out,
She's
out.
She left her
out.
Yeah.
She didn't even look behind her.
But you know, I guess, I do think that with the UK as well, I feel like there's more like attention and stuff. You can let me know how you feel about like, if you think it's true, but I feel like it's more attention like men and stuff. Oh, well, not really, women aren't really...
Especially in the hip-hop, like your genre.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I think that's very true.
100%. I mean, there's more men, so I guess...
Yeah, I guess.
It happens, but definitely there's like this thing. I feel like, the women in the game definitely have to work twice, not 10 times as hard as the guys.
But some of you are really better lyricists than...
100%.
Than the guys. That's what's crazy.
100%.
And some guys, because I wanted to get to this as well, some people have like ghostwriters and... all that, all that jazz. But we've learned that you write your stuff yourself.
I do. Yeah. I do.
Guys, don't come and beat me up, Paul, because I'm
sorry,
like,
but Cinderella, if she fits.
I'm not like a hip hop genius or whatever, but I honestly feel like to call yourself a rapper, you must write your own stuff.
Yeah.
But a lot of people nowadays,
they don't be doing that.
Have like biographers and authors writing.
Yeah.
Ghostwriters.
I think that's incredible. I think that I really think that's incredible. Seriously.
Thank you. I agree personally for me, and I know a lot of other people feel this way. But as rappers, just the writing process is very much a massive part of it. Obviously, the delivery is
yeah, because you're very like witty with your lyrics and like smart and like I told two babies here. But like, what's your creative process like?
Do you know what? A lot of my stuff comes from the production.
Okay.
So like I produce as well. So like,
look at that.
I get a feel from the production.
Okay.
And off of that, you know, my brain goes into the writing world. Like, how does this make me feel? What do I want to say in this kind of, you know, vibe? That's how it goes usually. But sometimes I write first, like I'll just be sitting down and something will come to my head and I'll write it down on my phone. And then gradually that'll build and then I'll get the beat made and then I'll fit it on there.
That's really sick.
So do you have like, you know when you go to a studio, do you have like any, I don't know, like do you have like incense and stuff? Like what's the studio vibe? Like I'm always
What's the ambiance like?
Yeah, everyone's got like a different kind of, you know,
it
routine
varies,
or whatever.
But like my home setup vibe, I definitely have incense going. But if I go studio, it's just one, either good people around me. The lighting, I'm all about the lighting. I can't have, sometimes in studios, it's like office lighting in there. And I was like, nah, this isn't, you know, so I need, red is my colour. Everyone's just like, red is so angry, so over. But I'm like, to me, it feels passionate. And it's, that's my thing. Red lighting. And I did take a detox from my Mary Jane, my marijuana. But I'm back.
Not
with
me
her.
Thinking Mary Jane Blige. What she do?
No, I got it.
I'm so sorry.
But yeah, I'm back with sis a little bit. So yeah, I'll probably roll a little spin and just enjoy.
Love it. Maybe, do you want to know as well?
I was gonna say maybe we might get invited to the studio because I feel like I've always wanted to see the creative process. Like, what's it like making a song?
Is it as fun as it looks though?
Do you know what? I say it is.
Okay.
Say it is. There's moments like sometimes you'll make a song, it's been 20 minutes, an hour, you've done it, it's all. And there's other things that could take weeks, months. Yeah. Like, I can't get this line or this just isn't working.
Yeah.
But I think there's beauty in the process nonetheless.
Yeah. Do you have a go-to person that you work with or like, are you open to like working with like different producers and like different engineers and stuff?
I'm open.
Okay.
I'm not like a studio sket. But I'm open. I'm like,
I love your choice of words.
I'm definitely open. I've got like my in-house crew that I know, when we get in, it's a straight banger.
Yes,
there's no questions. But there's a few like SV. He produced the track that I'm literally dropping like in a couple of days.
We're gonna get into that, by the way. You're not gonna get into that. But yes.
So yeah, there's him, there's Delirious, Big Zico, Jacques. There's quite a few. There's some serious producers out there. And like I said, I produce myself as well. So
love that.
I'll throw my name in the bag as well.
Oh, of course, of course. How did you get started with music there?
I say my dad, he was an MC back in his day. So he just had all the sound system, all the records, everything. My living room was like, it was like a studio. The sofas, was like, what's the point of it? What's the point? But yeah, just from morning, crack of dawn. Speakers bouncing the place. K-Putin, Sizzler, just bare reggae, dancehall music. Just literally, it was like, it was just going through my veins, my pores. It was just leaking into me and I was just, I was obsessed. It was like I was
meant
fascinated.
To be,
that's amazing.
I literally sit in front of the speakers and just digest all these things. I guess naturally my parents then saw how it, the impact it had on me. So then they encouraged it, put me in stagecoach, Brit school, different performing arts schools. And I've just carried on. Yeah. It's just something I did. Even when I wasn't at school, I'd be in the playground with my friends, I'm beatboxing, I'm spitting, and it's just been a part of
that is so cool.
I love the encouragement part because I feel like a lot of parents would be like, music? Like, you could
read your books.
Read your books. What do you mean about music? But I love that.
My mum did get to, there was a point like when I was maybe in year 8 and I was starting to get with the wrong crowd. I'm not even really focusing too tough on music or acting stuff that she thought. So it got to a point she was just like, if I'm not going to be doing that, like properly, then forget about it. Be a nurse, be a doctor, lawyer, they want you to do all
engineer,
that academic
goodness me
stuff. It did get to a point. And then I had to just say to her, sorry, please. I know what I'm doing.
That's good. Especially at a young age. I feel like when you know at a young age what you want and you stick to it, I think that's really true.
That's
as
a blessing.
Because Lord knows me, I'd be like flip flopping. I want to do this one moment. I want to do this the next.
Honestly.
So no, I think as long as you know what you want and you stick to it, I think it pays off all the time. I feel
definitely.
So
I was gonna ask as well, what is like the most exciting part of from when you write music all the way to like releasing to performing? Like, what part is just the part that you always look forward to the most, or you enjoy the most?
There's so many parts that are so lit, but I'm a stage girl.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Like, it's like I'm going home when I walk out on that stage with that microphone and I look out and then people there.
Yeah.
That's like, yeah, that's it for me. It's like everything I've, like I said, some things have taken months to write, years, or it's been years to release even. Yeah. So it's like that moment of just being able to take it from just my little brain, me in the studio recording, to now expressing it live to you. It's like, yeah, that to me, that's top notch for me.
I've always wondered what that feels like, you know, like being on stage and having people like dancing, singing along, like that must, the adrenaline must be crazy.
Oh, the adrenaline is, you don't even realize. Like sometimes I look back at footage and I'm like, am I all right? I'll be bouncing off the speakers. I'm doing dance moves I didn't even know I could do.
But that's so exciting.
Just,
yeah.
Honestly, it just, it takes over you and it's lit because, you know, the energy that they give you,
you feedback
then
into,
give
yeah.
back and it's just this beautiful exchange, you know?
Yeah.
I always said if I was an artist, I feel like that would be the most exciting part.
Performing
like
on
to
stage,
actually go out on stage and then see like just so many heads and if people know your lyrics, I'd flipping cry.
Yeah, yeah.
I wouldn't be able to rap. I'd be crying. I'm like, oh my gosh, you guys know my words. Like, it's amazing.
No, legit, legit.
Yeah, no, it's a lit feeling. And like, yeah, even like when you're in different countries, like I was in Spain the other day for a show. And it's just like, as much as they might not even have a clue what I'm saying, the fact that this is still touching
they're still
me,
vibing.
Yeah. It's like, yeah, that's very special.
Yeah.
That's amazing. What's that?
No, I was going to say, so I saw that Drake follows you.
He does.
And I love Drake.
No, listen. Listen.
So
I don't think Drake loves Drake the way this girl loves Drake.
I need to know, is it like a secret society that I gotta join?
Oh my days.
For drinks.
But you gotta rap. You're in podcast, so you gotta rap.
Like, I need to know, where is the link? Like, what happened, girl? I need to follow back.
That's
you know coming. What?
I've been dying to ask you that, honestly.
May, I don't know. I was.
Do you know him? Have you met him? Like,
we've never met, but we've spoken. I have his number. We've texted.
Wait.
Don't say that.
Pause.
She's gonna try to steal your phone.
You have Drake's number?
Yeah.
Guys, I'm getting one step closer. We're getting one step closer.
I'm actually going to cry at home.
See, I think you're my favourite guest.
Oh, I love that.
My favourite guest.
Love that.
I love you already, honestly.
Funny.
Yeah,
that
is
hilarious.
Really cool.
I know, it is crazy. Sometimes I'm just like, huh?
Do you get like weird when like artists follow you back and stuff? Because that must be a crazy feeling. Like people that are like really up there.
It is definitely because like, you know, I've been watching Drake from early and just seeing how massive he has gotten and he's had on just everything.
Oh my God, I'm so excited.
seeing him pop up in my things is just like, like, what?
Yeah.
A little old me from crawling you.
I love that
feeling. You see me. Love struck eye certain time, you know, girls.
You're killing her.
Why are you doing this slowly? You're killing me slowly.
Sorry.
No, but that's really good. I love that. I know that with Drake, obviously, I'd be saying what I say on here. I like Drake.
He might be watching, yeah?
I know. But obviously, I like Drake, whatever. But not as much as she does. She's another level.
Right.
But I love the fact that he does support, like, UK artists.
Mm. He does.
And I would say he's the most supportive, I think. Well, at least out loud.
I feel like, he doesn't, it's not, you know, secretly saying, oh, this is lit. Like, he'll actively follow, like, keep up.
Yeah.
He follows Link Up TV, see him liking every post from there. Like, he actually is interested in the culture. Some people say it's for vulture purposes, but I think
it's genuine, yeah.
Yeah, I think just like a lot of us, just music, it doesn't matter. You can have one follower, you could be the biggest person if it connects. It connects. So yeah, I think he's like that.
So what do you think like we need to do to get like UK music like up there, especially like in terms of like female
boy artists? I would say just
support.
Be prepared for what I'm about to do and
love it.
And yeah, support it because I think it's just about the product. If the product is great, there's no reason for you to not support it. I feel like there's sometimes people would just support, oh it's my friend, oh so you're gonna support, you're gonna try. And but if you genuinely don't actually think it's great, it's not a great product, it's not by force. I feel like there's a lot of nonsense that can be pushed
facts
and facts. Yeah, I think it's just about really pushing and supporting
yeah.
the actual talent and the, you know, the great products. And yeah, naturally it should do what it needs to do.
Because I think we do have this kind of culture where we don't like to support people. We like, basically, we like to see other people support someone before we then jump on a bad bandwagon. Mm-hmm. And I don't know why that is. It's very childish, I think.
Yeah.
But people can actually like, and we've said it, we've talked about it even with our podcast, but people can see what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
They like what you're doing. They admire what you're doing. But until like someone else acknowledges, someone that they maybe respect or whatever, or they see as a bigger level than you, acknowledge that they're like, oh, yes, I do like your, do you get me? And it's like, okay, hon. All right.
Yeah. That's very much a UK thing, which and it's been that way. I don't know why.
Yeah.
But yeah, hopefully as time goes on, that's something we can eradicate. And just from you like it, you like it.
Yeah,
X, Y, Z, don't need to co-sign nothing.
Yeah.
When you write and stuff, do you like, what's the word I'm trying to find? Do you send it to, or like, get basically not get someone's approval.
Opinions.
But like, yeah, opinions, that's it.
I do what I like to call consumer research.
Okay.
So I might just, I'll play something. I'm not going to say to you, oh, listen to this new, what do you think? I'm just going to play it.
Okay.
And I'll see the natural reaction.
To it, yeah.
If there's sometimes people having conversation and then they hear it and they have to stop their conversation.
Okay.
And that lets me know, okay, this
you like
piqued
it.
Your interest and that is, that's a good sign. Or people will be like, oh, who's that? Or what's this? And so yeah, just things like that I'll do, but I'm not really, I'm also somebody that is my art. So as much as I might hear some opinions, at the end of the day, how I feel about it is what's
most important.
Because you've got a new single coming out as well. So it's like, how do you pick? Like, okay, this is the song. This is gonna be it. Like, what's the thought process behind it?
It's difficult, right? Because I write so much music, right? So sometimes I'm just like, I just want to drop something every day. This is how I feel today. Drop this one, but obviously can't do that. So I think it's just about like the time,
okay?
Right. So now I should say we're in summer.
Mm-hmm.
So the music I'm gonna release right now is. Summer feels that you know you can drop the roof on your whip and you can go to the club, you're gonna
love it.
And obviously there's, you know, I feel like the slower moments or the deeper moments, sometimes, as you know, we're coming into autumn or winter times, now you wanna kick back fireplace or whatever, and you're gonna
I
feel like I go with the seasons.
It sounds like you do like a lot of you're very involved in like the business side of your career.
Because coming into this, sometimes you can be like naive. I make music, and I had to rap, everybody loves me, let's go. But there's obviously like so many other layers. It's like a onion. Artists, you're just there as the skin, and you're just thinking there's nothing. There's one bag of things going on behind it. So yeah, it's good to at least try and understand some of it, because there is a lot. So to know all of it might not be, you know, feasible. But having a basic understanding of some things is good. And I guess the more you do it, the more you learn as you go along. I'm not somebody that likes to pretend that I know it all. Like, I'm somebody going to ask questions. Like, what does that mean? Like, what are you talking about?
Is there any particular reasons that you made you want to get proper involved? Or is it just, like you were saying, you just for your knowledge and stuff?
I mean, there's a mixture. Like, I went to uni and I studied music industry management.
Okay.
And that was just because I just wanted to have some sort of understanding so I wouldn't get, you know, ginned. I still ended up getting ginned. But that's...
When you first got into the industry. I feel like that's kind of... happens to a lot of people,
It does. So yeah, as much as I may have learnt some stuff, there were still things I didn't know, and people were able to swindle me that way. So I think that definitely has allowed me to want to get to know more as well, to ensure you'll never get me like that again, ever, you know? So yeah, I think that's something that everyone should try and focus on.
It's important to know like what you're getting yourself into, isn't it? Because like you're saying, it's very easy to get swindled nowadays because everybody's just hungry for a bit of money and all that stuff. And Yeah, it's a lot. Yeah. But you also mentioned about getting rid of friends.
Yeah. She said, let me sit up for this one.
Now, I feel like when you get to a certain, like, certain position or certain level, do you feel like it's very easy for people to take advantage of you or feel pressure to, like, take care of friends? Because I've watched a few documentaries and stuff, and, like, a lot of artists talking about how, like, they have to look after their family, mm-hmm. then their friends, stuff like that, because you're in a better position now where you can.
Yeah. Yeah.
So did you ever feel like certain friends were, like, maybe taking advantage?
Absolutely.
Or, like, you know, you had to do certain stuff because you was Nadia now?
100%. I feel like, position this. Yeah, I feel like people were definitely taking advantage. Mm. At the time, I didn't see it. Mm-hmm. At the time, I'm just like, yeah, man, these are my dogs. I'm just, yeah. Same way they got me, I got them, mm. and they're nice. Gonna, no, it wasn't that at all. It's like, if somebody needs a favor, mm. or I'm a bit low on change, or I need to pay my rent, or I didn't, I'm automatically gonna be like, yeah, got you.
Let me help you. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Gonna help. Absolutely. No questions asked. But then it was like, when things flipped, now I need support. I couldn't turn to nobody.
Nobody's there.
There was absolutely nobody there. And it was painful when I actually really looked around and I've said, wow. Every time you was in a pickle, no matter which way it was, it could have been financial, could have been personal, whatever it was, I supported you. But then on the flip side, it didn't happen. So yeah, that was definitely an eye opener. And do you know what? A blessing in disguise.
Absolutely.
I'm glad it went as it did.
Yeah.
I think people underestimate, like, losing friends. And because I know, like, a lot of guys joke around, like, oh, girls, we make a big deal of friendships. But there's it in a way that your friends are kind of your sisters.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
when
it's a
you
sisterhood.
Lose a, yeah, it's a sisterhood. And when you lose friends, it's a heartbreak, you know.
Mm.
It's actually a heartbreak. It's actually very, very deep. But I think that realization, when you realize that you do for more for people than they would do for you. And it's okay, because I feel like God gives to each person as they can handle, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it might be a case where I have more and I'm able to help out, and there's a reason for that.
Mm-hmm.
But I think even in sometimes in little people have where they actually can help you and they choose not to, it's a very, very sad realization. But like you said, I don't believe that I've lost anybody that's meant to be in my life.
Right.
Like, I always believe that you weren't here, you're not meant to be here for the rest of the journey. So where we've got up to, thank you. I've learned lessons. Thank you very much.
Right.
Taking them on board, moving forward. But ding ding, this is your stop.
Yeah.
you can get off this train. Thank
not
you very
the ding
much.
Ding.
Yeah. Ding ding. 100%. But then sometimes I was like, I had to look at myself as well. Like, was I an enabler?
Am I the problem?
Yeah.
Sometimes you have to do that.
You know, was I an enabler? Instead of me saying no sometimes, like, you've got to try and, or helping and then encouraging them to figure something out. It was just like, no, I'm just going to help you and you're going to do nothing about that, and then help you again. And then, yeah. So then I'm like, am I an enabler? But really, no.
That's it. I love it. Straight up. No.
Yeah.
Cool.
No, that's really cool. But yeah, so you mentioned your new single.
Yes.
And, you know, a little birdie. The road we're all on. It's a very intimate road we're on. But yeah, that Daisy, who we've also had on the pod, an absolute babe. Yeah, we have. We had to meet in person because it was during COVID.
Yeah.
Then remote episodes was kicking my ass.
it was a lot.
Zoom.
So we're yet to actually need to have her again back in the studio. Yeah. But a very lovely babe. And we're hearing that she directed the music video for that.
Yeah, she did.
Could you let us know how that came about?
Yeah.
I know. It was like, it was very interesting. Like I said, this whole thing is a process from the leaving my brain onto the paper, onto the microphone, into the mixing, into the video. Is a whole process. But Daisy, I met this year, earlier this year, and just naturally, it was like she heard the music and just naturally
loved it.
Yeah, she just loved it. One, and she could just visualize things.
Oh, wow, sick.
And it was just a natural kind of back and forth of, right, this is what I can see in my brain.
Yeah.
And then she'd take what I could see in my brain and implement things and give it an arc. I think, you know. And yeah, she works with a girl called Anna and on the directing of the video. Somebody else meant to direct it before, but that went Pete Tong. And I think that was for a reason.
Mm.
So yeah, just ended up with Daisy and Anna, and what we have been able to produce is absolutely incredible.
Lovely.
I'm so excited for you guys to see it.
Yeah. Okay.
On the way, y'all.
On the way.
It's on the way. And yeah, it's been a great process, yeah. Honestly. And yeah, Daisy is a big vibe, and I'll definitely be doing more with her. Yeah.
Okay. What should we expect?
Ooh, what should you expect? I think, so you can expect what you would expect from me.
Okay.
But elevated.
Love okay, that. Growth.
Growth.
Love that.
I love it.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Absolutely love that. Did you guys see the Versus the other day?
Which one was
Omarion? Omarion versus Mario.
I saw a few clips.
Ciao.
First of all, who did you guys think? Who were you guys betting on?
I was so confident. I'm so glad I didn't do any bets, because I would have bet my salary on the fact that Mario was going to win.
Yeah.
Really?
He didn't.
Really?
Mario won.
Oh.
I know.
I'm not shocked, you know.
I am.
Because I feel like with Mario, it's a lot of, the dancing does a lot of
talking
for him.
But was he able to do B2K tracks as well?
He did, but in the manner in which he did it,
it wasn't
he
B2K. Shouldn't have.
That's what the streets are saying.
It was R2K.
Not R2K.
No shade.
But you know, I wanted to know, then, before we even get into that tea, yeah, like, if you, because personally, I feel like the reason why, so there was two parts of it, right? So the earlier part was Ray J and Bobby Valentino and right. Pleasure P and Sammy, right?
Right.
They went against each other as well. Ray J as well. Okay. The second part, the main show was Omarion and Mario.
Right.
So obviously, in the first part, I can't lie, I thought Bobby V and Ray J would win against Pleasure P and Sammy, right? Even though obviously Pleasure P is pre-Ricky. And then the second part, I also thought, again, Omarion. But I think that essentially, and I think a lot of people thought this as well, the underdogs outperformed.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's because people thought they weren't going to do that great. And I think as well, is because the ones who felt like they're more popular probably didn't feel like they had to put in as much work into prep.
Yeah.
So I wanted to ask that, if you were gonna do a versus, how would you prep for that?
Oh, and who would be on your team?
How would I prep? I mean, I guess I would prep for it like I prep for like tours or the same way I know I'm either gonna be, there's gonna be fans that already know me that, you know, I want to retain them. I don't want them to come and see me now and be like, second guessing things.
Yeah.
And there's also going to be people that maybe are discovering me now, and I need to make sure, I've got you now, you're locked. So yeah, that just means it's got to be flawless. I need to know everyone. Step to the left, I know it. Heel and toe, I know it. Just breath control, everything, eye contact, interaction.
Yeah.
I need to know everything.
It's all in the details.
It's in the details.
Sometimes
details.
I forget, you know, that artists have to do all of these things, because I just think, sometimes I think you guys just come on stage and just do your thing.
Yeah.
And you're off.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of it is natural. Yeah. A lot of it is definitely natural. You can just go and do that. But it's a performance as well. You have to give it that extra. Yeah. It's not just me in my bedroom, Howard. No, this is
it's not TikTok.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's a full of performance.
There's levels to this. And like you say, there's gonna be, you know, it's going to be the new up and comers. They're hungry. Mm. You know, it's that first taste of, their hunger is, it's extreme. So you don't want to be shown up. You you have to, no matter what stage you're at, I always just think, you have to go in.
Yeah.
100%.
If you had an artist to come support you to like, make sure you get that win, who would it be?
Could be anybody.
Anyone. I'm hoping you're going to say someone that I just mentioned, but it's okay if you don't.
Do you know what? Who am I going to bring?
And the song you want them to play.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. That's giving you homework. Yeah, bring two, okay?
No, I'm bringing three. Sorry, girls.
Okay.
No, that's right. Go, it's your verses. I'm bringing for the vibes.
I'm bringing Spice.
Do you know what? I was hoping you say Spice.
She's going to bring Spice energy.
And I wanted to make that entrance with the luggage that she had. I don't know if you like,
I got the bar from it.
That's how I needed to pull up. Rihanna. My good sis Rihanna, who follows me as well, by the way. Did you know that one?
Listen.
I'm going to have to steal your phone.
I absolutely love this.
Riri, 100%. And lastly, Little Kim.
Ooh, that's a share. You can't lose. I don't care. Yeah. You can't lose.
You've got variety.
You get it. It's a strong trio.
Yeah.
It's a strong
that's
trio.
That's the gang, gang.
You're bringing it.
Oh, one more. Sorry. One more. Just to give it an extra, like this is.
Yeah.
This is like a separate, but Jill Scott.
Ooh, no, you take it as a church.
Yeah, I get the separate, but you mean, okay, because she's going to. The soul. Yeah.
Jill?
Yeah. Yeah. I can't, like, the way you're thinking and stuff. Okay, no pressure.
Right.
I can't wait for a show. I'm not, no pressure.
Yeah.
I'm right. Putting it out there. I feel like the production levels are really going to hit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You're thinking really you're into thinking, it. Yeah.
I have to.
Like, you're taking me there.
That. I have to. Something for love everyone. It. Connect with every part of it. Yeah.
Yes.
Ooh. I love that.
Ooh. Who's an artist that you would love to work with?
Well, apart from all the ladies I just mentioned, J. Cole.
That's one of her favorite
girls. Girl.
Here's the pause.
But when I saw you and I saw the skin and I knew the talent, I said, I know I like her on a deeper level.
I'm telling you, she's, you're our favorite.
Dreamville, all the way.
Oh, my days. J. Cole, I have, like, from I was, I'm going to say about 12 years now, I've been a J. Cole fan. I saw his first performance in the UK at Coco Camden. That show changed my life. Like, really? I feel like I actually made the decision to be serious about my thing after that show. So, and just his lyricism, just everything. There's no box he doesn't tick for me.
I agree.
So, I would definitely love that.
Of course you agree.
No, but I'll be honest, J. Cole does have that thing where he can switch something in your life.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even when I like, so basically, you know the song Crooked Smile?
Yes.
Crooked Smile is why I have as much confidence as I have today.
Love that.
Honestly, I can't even describe what it was that it switched, but it just switched something in me where I was like, I've got to love myself more, accept myself more. Still work on myself, of course, because self-awareness.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But it just did something. It's a very pivotal moment in my growth.
Yeah. He does that.
Love that.
That's amazing. Do you have a music mentor?
I don't. I would say my managers and my girl, my family.
Okay.
Are like their vibe mentors, I guess.
And that
translates into the music.
If you could have a music mentor, would you have like who would you want it to be?
Ooh. I might have to say Dark Child.
Ooh. He is a fantastic, fantastic producer.
The talent is wild.
Fantastic. I would go Dark Child.
Mm. Yeah.
And Teddy Riley. Oh. Mm.
Yeah. That's a combo.
Yeah.
I feel like you like a bit of everything. Like, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, my taste is very eclectic. I'm like, there's nothing that you can bring me. I don't care. You can say, oh, it's country. Let me hear it.
Let me hear it.
I want to hear it. I'm not restricted.
Is there a sound you want to go, like a genre you'd want to experiment one day? Or like, not even experiment, because you kill it, but you want to go into?
Yeah.
I would love to do like some punk. Like not full on rock all the way in.
Like, I want to die.
It has to be full far, but some rock punk.
Okay.
Give us that, you know. Mm. I'll be interested. No, absolutely. Like a lot of black people don't really go into that. I'll be really interested to know. Because you know Kay Michelle, she did country.
Yeah.
And I think it did really, like it did all right.
It did
right.
Do well. Yeah, it did well.
So
she had that someone who was really known in the respect there as well.
You can't say that.
You've got talent.
Even Beyonce with Break My Soul, the Unts and stuff, is working.
Yeah.
So you never know.
That's really cool.
You heard it here first, guys.
Really? And I've been seeing you don't use your headphones.
Do you know what? So basically, I'm doing this political stance, right? So on TDA, I'm sure Brent told you about it the day after, right?
Yeah.
The show we do every day. So that is usually my seat. Where you're sitting, that's where I sit on the show, right? So I don't feel like I have as much. Brent's gonna hate me for this. I hope he doesn't listen to this. I don't feel like I have as much lighting as I would like to have. And so when I have the headset, right, I just look like a floating forehead. So I said, in all honesty, Brent, I can hear what's going on. So we've got like a music cues, right, for like each segment, right?
Mm.
So what I do, I leave it next to me. I can hear everything, and I said I can't lie. Like I would like to at least look somewhat cute.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So that is my start. So now, he mocks me for it because sometimes he plays stuff And I'll be like, oh, why is it silent? He'll be like, well, if you had the headset on. So my hearing is like A1 now. Uh-huh. So now even when I'm on No Shade, I have to kind of carry on with it. Just, yeah, to, yeah. Just again, it's just part of, it's our love language. I like to wind him up.
Right.
So yeah.
Yeah,
makes sense.
But Akuya's following the rules, so it's great. Well, at least one
no,
of
no, it's because I like to be able to hear and make sure that we've got the right
okay
sound levels.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just running on vibes. but yes, I want to talk about Beyonce's new single.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't expecting that at all.
Mm.
But when I heard it first, I thought this is very different for Beyonce.
Yeah.
But then I thought, I like it. And I realized the reason why I like it is because it's Beyonce. I never really thought I was a Beehive. Like, I'm not like the Beehive. The Beehives are
scary.
It's a different.
Yeah.
Dare I say it's a cult. But actually, I'm joking, guys. I'm joking. Please don't. If it beats my comments, I'm joking.
They're coming for me.
But like, when I heard, I thought, do you know what? Like, I think because I respect Beyonce and I'm here for it, I think the delivery was great. I will say, I do hope the entire album isn't house.
Yeah, because
I think there's only so much instance I can take.
Yeah.
But
I don't think she did a whole album, Nancy.
Because you know it's a two-part album.
Oh, for
is
real?
Because it's Renaissance 1. So surely it should be Renaissance 2.
Two. Right, okay.
But
so I'm thinking maybe
track list is on oh no, you mean as in she's gonna release another one?
Yeah, another one. Yeah, it's to be continued kind of vibe. So yeah, what do you guys think when you heard it?
Yeah.
I'll be real, I haven't heard it like in its entirety. Yeah.
No, you're really away from the world. love it. Oh my gosh, I need tips.
Girl.
Because I don't like it out here.
You have to do it. Oh, it's beautiful. But what I have heard and the reactions I've seen.
Yeah.
I feel like some of it is partly what you're saying is because it's Beyonce.
Beyonce, yeah.
And some of it is just general. Yeah, I like this vibe.
Yeah.
People, you know, like we said, summer is coming.
Yeah. And I think it's that.
And months away, you know.
I'm not going to lie. At first I was like, what is this? This ain't you, Beyonce? This is not you.
Beyonce?
What are you doing? Beyonce? Beyonce, what are you doing? And then I was like, well, let me listen to it properly.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, it's a bop. It's a little vibe. Do you know what
I
think? Yeah.
I really feel like any artist here, if you want to introduce a new sound, I genuinely feel, unless it's like a slow vibe, I really think doing it before summer is when to do it. When the sun is shining, if you release Silence, that's the best Silence I ever heard in my life. I just think there's something about the sun.
Yeah.
There's something about summer coming.
Yeah.
Especially for the girls.
Yeah.
Hot girl summer. Nah, release it.
I think sampling also helps, you know.
But some of it is getting a bit.
It's a bit much.
Please leave it.
There's
an art to it because I don't want to mention no names, but there's one artist from the UK that sampled one of my favorite songs by Ashanti. This is
Akuya. I'm obsessed with that song. You know, I did like a whole 30-minute like wait session.
Wait,
if you know, you know.
And I just felt like
I'm in shock.
That song is one of Ashanti's, like, you know when you know like Ashanti, you know that song. Like,
I'm gonna
just say that's her song, right?
These are the views of Akuya and Akuya only. You can invite me to the shows. I will be there.
Listen, I'm gonna have a free ticket. If you want to, I'll come. But I have to be honest. This is, do you know what I mean? I feel like as artists, I'm not an artist, but as consumers, we have to be honest.
Okay.
We can't like everything.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? And I think sometimes that's where sometimes it can be a bit techie in the UK. Mm. I think people are not very accepting the fact that
criticism.
Not everyone. Yeah. Yeah, or like, do you know what? Sometimes it's just taste.
Mm. Yeah.
It's just taste.
Yeah.
But I will say, I worked out, like, when I tell you, you know what? I rarely have to use that. You know when you have a loop on your whatever platform you're listening on? But you know the one with the one?
Mm-hmm.
Where it's just the same song?
Same song, yeah.
I was honestly listening to it for like a full-on wait session. Yeah. I said, I am obsessed with this.
It's, you know what?
But I think it's taste, again. I don't think it's taste.
I just think there's certain songs you do it if you're going to do it, that song, do it well.
Mm.
Otherwise, just leave it alone. And I feel like with Beyonce, with Break My Soul, I think it's like a classic, right? It's what song was it? I can't remember. I think her name was Robin or something. But yeah, no, it's one of the classics. I just feel like she did it well. Mm-hmm. So I feel like when you hear the song, you hear the sample, and you're like, okay, that's a banger.
Mm-hmm.
And you've done it well. So it's all right. Whereas some people just think you do it and it's just,
yeah. Yeah, a lot of it feels forced.
And very TikTok-y. And I know that's like the it thing now, but...
It shouldn't be.
Oh, it's something to show me love.
Yeah, you got to show me love.
Yeah, I must listen back. I didn't get that. I did not get that. What? I'm seeing that.
The beehive are going to come for you.
Because I didn't hear something. They can't, sorry, you can't discriminate on my hearing. That's rude. Do you know what? Okay, I'm going to listen back to it and I might pick it up. But I was going to, actually go on.
No, I was just going to say, do you, like, if there was a song that you was going to sample,
yeah,
what song would it be?
I want to tell, basically, one of my things coming soon is actually with a sample.
Ooh. Okay.
Tastefully done, my song.
I love it.
But I don't want to tell you what the sample is.
Okay, it's like, no, you wear it. Do you know what? So we know it's coming.
Do you know what? We can guess it when it comes out.
Yeah. But it's a classic. Okay. And it's not like, it's bait in a sense that one, when you hear it, you're like, it's going to be like that. What's that?
Yeah.
It's not straight away.
Oh, like a guy's in it.
It's like,
like some
that?
People.
It's going to be like a little earworm for a second.
Okay.
It's going to, yeah, that's what I like. When I hear sample tunes, I like to be like, wait, and that, what's that?
I can't like, I love it. Yeah. It's like the artist has sent me a little challenge.
Yes.
Because honestly, there's a song I listened to. Who was it? It was, she's Nigerian artist, Asha. Have you heard of her? Mm-hmm. And she's got a song. And I was like, this song is tapping to a memory from when I was a kid.
Mm-hmm.
I could not remember it for so long. And I literally was like, I think it's like end of the day or maybe the day after. And I'm in the gym. I said,
yeah,
I know the song. Like, I love it. I love that moment. I'm like, I know it.
And I think that's how it should be done.
Yeah.
I think it shouldn't be too obvious, but not so hard where I'm like, oh my God, like, like with you and Beyonce, where you
do. No clue. As soon as I leave, I need to listen to this. Like, I'm like thinking, But I want to get your opinion on that as well, actually. So I feel like during lockdown, especially, we kind of saw the rise of like music and TikTok.
Mm-hmm.
And essentially some artists feel like they have to release
TikTok songs.
Yeah. And essentially, because obviously I can't like, TikTok is definitely doing amazing things for music.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Definitely. But you as an artist, do you feel that pressure of, I've got to make something that bangs on TikTok, or are you separating yourself from that?
Yeah, no, I'm not one of them. I just make the music, and if it does,
what it does
it
cool.
then brilliant. But that's not my driving force. It's not like, oh, I must make this TikTokable music. Because I don't really think, because all the music that goes like viral or is popping on there, I don't really think, some of it, you couldn't have said it was a TikTokable song.
Yeah.
It's just someone has, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I agree.
A lot of it has just been, oh, this just works for this thing.
Yeah, actually,
So, yeah, I feel like there's some things that now people are calling TikTok songs that aren't actually TikTok songs.
Yeah.
Done what it needed to do on TikTok. But, yeah, there are a lot of, you know, that person was sitting in there saying,
I want this song.
There's a couple.
I need a dance and everything as well. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a couple. There's a couple.
That's interesting. Yeah.
So we've also been watching Love Island. We love talk about Love Island.
Yeah.
Have you been watching Love Island?
Been watching. I mean, me and babes are catching up.
Okay.
We're a bit behind, like we said, you know, like a hiatus and away from the world for a second. So,
okay, I'll try not to ruin it.
I mean, it's been ruined.
I can't lie to you. If you're not watching, I missed yesterday's one and I accepted it was going
to
be ruined.
I'm going to try. But there's one specific like storyline in there that I really wanted to touch upon.
She's definitely seen it. I feel like I might as well just say it.
Okay, so the India and Sammy situation.
Okay, right.
You've seen that, please?
I haven't seen, but I know that it's happened.
It's happening.
Yeah. So it's happening, right? So I don't know if you know that he was coupled up with Amber before.
Yes.
Yeah.
And did you see her post?
She's bad
pretending that she was
in Cannes.
Oh, I haven't seen it.
And she was just in London.
The investigators caught her. So
oh, no.
Yeah.
And it was very calculated because she had like, basically, she's in lingerie, which is great. Get your body, girl. And then she was like, and then like the location said Cannes or whatever.
Then
the caption was to do with like chess and playing checkers. Mm-hmm. And then she's got a chessboard. I said,
this is recently.
Girl, this was like 2 days ago.
The post, the original post was 45 weeks ago. Right, but she posted it yesterday or 2 days ago as if it was current.
Oh, girl. Yeah.
So it made it seem as if like, she left Love Island. No, she said, catching flights.
Yeah, catching
not
flights.
Feeling
not feeling
so much chest and checking. So it looks as if she left the villa. She's like, I don't really care.
Yeah,
I don't care.
Yeah.
And then went to
big girl lifestyle
in France.
Yeah.
No, girl.
Oh,
that's not what happened.
You were in this 17 degrees that we're in.
No.
Don't try it.
But yeah. Yeah, so mm-hmm. yeah, she, her and India were like Love Island friends. Me, I yes. don't think they were friends. Because
I saw people saying that they didn't think it was genuine no. like that. Yeah,
yeah, I mean, on. Even if it was genuine and she liked the girl, I don't think it was like a friendship where it's like, I can't date your ex.
Yeah.
Kind of thing. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. What are your thoughts on like the situation and if exes, like friends, your friends
like
ex.
Yeah, is there a girl code in that?
Of slimming. Because we talked about this before and we have different
don't
opinions.
Don't sound at me.
We don't think the same on this.
Oh.
What are your okay. thoughts? She's looking at you like, mm.
It's, mate.
Okay, speak on it hypothetically. But we don't want to ruin your situation when you leave here. It's like, no shit, I'm never going back on there.
No, it's all good. Right, okay, so wait, hold on. Are you talking about like the dynamic of Amber and India?
Yeah, do you mm-hmm. think, because you know how people are saying, oh, it's like, some people are saying it's wrong for them to start something when, yeah. you know, they didn't tell Amber and now that she's left, like they're trying to be all, like trying to be the couple.
I don't think, especially not in like a show like that.
Yeah.
I think in Love Island, boy,
go on anything goes.
King. Yeah, just get it. But in a real life
yeah.
It is.
Put yourself in that situation, hypothetically. Guys, if you guys was in this room right now.
We don't typically ruin them, our guest relationships. Put that out there.
I don't think it's the thing to do.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, not sneakily anyway. Mm-hmm. I think if there's a genuine thing, then just be honest and open about it.
Yeah, 100%.
Just boom. I'm not gonna lie, I do have these feelings towards, mm-hmm. you know, and yeah, I think communication is key in all situations.
Yeah.
But it's a techie one when you really think about it.
Yeah.
What are your guys? Who's where? Who's with what?
I think it's a straight no. Basically, let me give you another scenario, right? So there's this girl, right, who's at work and she's a bridesmaid, yeah?
Right.
And basically, the bride's...
It's a real life story?
Yeah, it's a real life story. Okay. So the bride's friend... No, the bride's... The groom...
Okay, start again. You lost me now. I'm like,
no,
who is this about?
I'm trying to explain it. Basically, yeah. The groom introduced his friend to one of the bridesmaids.
Right? Okay, yeah.
Yeah, but another one of the bridesmaids has been out with the groom's friend.
Okay.
So there's two bridesmaids who...
Are they linked to the same guy?
Yeah, one is past, one is present. Okay. And the two bridesmaids met through the bride and now they're friends.
Okay.
Right. You get it?
Okay.
But now, one of the bridesmaids is the new one who's with the guy the current one is saying, oh, you can't date the guy because I've been there.
No, so that's the past. So the past is saying the current can't date the guy.
Yeah.
Girl, so, bye.
But all they did was just kiss and went on a few dates.
Furthermore, anyway, sorry, but do I know you? Or do I know you because of the wedding?
And the past is in a 5-year relationship.
What?
I don't care.
So why do you care?
Yeah.
Right now.
Yeah. Personally, she makes a scene, I'll report her to her husband or to her partner. Don't be silly. Because you've got a man of 5 years and you're worrying about what I'm doing even though you had one little lips.
But it's like this whole thing of like friends not dating each other.
We're
like,
not friends.
Right.
That's
we're
bad.
Not friends.
You're bad.
No, because no. We're bridesmaids to the same bride and groom.
Yeah, but
we're not friends.
But we're
man.
All in a friendship group.
No, because of this wedding.
Yes.
When the wedding finished,
and
the group chat is disseminated.
It's finished, right, exactly.
That's it.
No. Before the wedding, like the red, they're all friends. So my thing is there levels to like, is it a thing where if you just kissed, it's still a no? Or if you guys were in a proper relationship?
Yeah.
Like, do you know what I mean? Like, is there levels to dating friends exit? Yeah, the exes of your friends?
Right. So I think there's levels. One, what's the level of friendship?
First of all. Yes. That's the most important part.
Do you get it? Obviously, if it's like your bestie or you're like close, like that, that's very off limits.
Mm.
But if it's like a distant kind
of. Like a walk by, hello.
Yeah.
The only time I see you is like a random barbecue or something.
Right.
But you have in between, like, you know, the people who are not
in between,
best friends.
I don't think.
Okay.
Because
any in between acting up, you'll be uninvited from the wedding. It's only in between. So there's no straight connection here.
See, this is where we differ. I just think everybody's off limits.
Nah,
like, I don't
mate.
Care if I, even if I had a crush on him, you're not going to date him. I'm honest with you,
yeah. I really? Think that, yeah. Personally, yeah, I think the dating scene is so in the mud that I can't afford
to lose
to potentially
out.
Lose out on good things.
Because
I'm doing girl code. Can't lie to you. My partner's not my friend.
Wow.
That's my best friend. That's my man. I'm going to sit beside him.
I'm so
dying. No, I just think it depends on the level of friendship. Like, if I dated your ex, that's wild.
Yeah.
Podcast done. The listeners was side with you.
Yeah.
But if
yeah.
it's like a friend, I can't lie. If it's like one of your friends.
Yeah, then.
Baby, I don't owe you nothing.
No, I get it.
100%.
I get it. If it's a friend, if it's a distant friend.
Yeah.
But anything from distance to in between to close. No.
Do you know what I'm losing it? Is that, yeah. Anything beyond immediate friend no longer classifies as a friend.
Right.
That's you are somebody shit. That I know associate. Mm-hmm. You're somebody that I know through my friend. Mm-hmm. So yeah. I don't really owe you anything. Because even like with friends, I feel like if I had like an ex of like, I don't know, from like years ago, whatever, and my friend, like someone who's actually my friend, meets him or and they get on and whatever, I think, honestly,
yeah.
I don't feel there's anything wrong with that. Because I, whatever, when the situation is done, and it's not a diss or anything, but like I heal from, like I,
it's finished.
When I'm done with you, sorry to that man, I don't know you. Do you get me? So I think,
yeah.
I think, especially when it's like time has gone by, and I think sometimes as well, like even if, this was someone that you were really, really hung up on or whatever. For whatever reason, it didn't work. You kind of get to the point where you realize why it didn't work.
Yeah.
And you're not the person for me. So you're not the person for me. Why should I then Blocked. Prevent you? But if my friend is actually going to be the love of your life, who knows? Maybe God used me as a person for you guys to meet.
Yeah, not going to lie. If that was me.
He's like, no.
I don't want to see it in my face. I'm not coming to your wedding.
Wow.
No. What do you mean?
So what if it's something that you discovered like after the fact? Like you've got to know this person.
Yeah.
His vibes. And then you discover that they was...
Feelings are already there.
I'm in love. There's nothing you can do about it.
Oh, look at that.
You see?
But it's different. Do you know why it's different, guys? Because I didn't know. If I knew... And I still, that's bad.
Yeah, but your code on the first scenario is so strong right. that I would expect your feelings exactly. to turn off.
No. If I didn't know, then I'm sorry, it is what it is. But if I knew, then yeah. that is bad.
I don't know. I just think that, do you know what it is though? Shout out to Nipsey Hussle. I think, yeah, no, not Nipsey, sorry. It's Lauren, but she said it about Nipsey.
Oh, yeah.
That he taught her that you don't own people.
Yeah.
Do you
mean?
You can't, and I think a lot of times we see relationships as like, this is my person.
Mm-hmm.
So you're my person. So when relationships then end, people don't know how to let go of the fact that that's no longer your person
yeah,
kind of thing.
Yeah. I agree.
I think go through, man.
Mm-hmm. I'm with
you. But I think if it's obviously someone, I think the only time I would accept like my friend saying to me, do you know what? No. Is if it's someone that's toxic. If the person's
if
mad.
That's the reason. It's not because they feel as if, oh, that's mine. How you gonna?
Yeah.
But if they're genuinely trying to look out for you, like, sis, that's not the one.
Yeah. Then, because that auntie in that case study with a 5-year relationship, her man is really looking at her sideways.
Yeah, no, she's
her
proper.
Her partner's looking at her sideways.
She's
because,
proper like, you can't date him. I can't believe a friend, you're even considering it. But all
Are
they did
okay?
was all they did was kiss and go on a couple of dates.
Primary school.
But even if you had a full-on relationship, I can't lie to you, you're 5 years in a new situation. Yeah. What's your situation saying?
Yeah. Right.
I'd be so offended as a partner. Yeah. I'd be so offended.
Mm.
What are you still looking for there?
That's the thing.
That's what I want to know.
Not facts.
I can't imagine my man telling me, imagine my boy trying to go out with my ex. And I'd be looking like, but I'm your current.
Excuse me?
Yeah.
Why are you upset?
Yeah.
Nah, it's crazy, man. It's but let's just pray for fresh meat. So that's what we can do.
Honestly, because dating scene is in a
I don't like drama.
Yeah, no, you can't.
I actually cannot.
Fresh is best.
Honestly. But just to kind of round out, we've honestly really enjoyed you coming.
Yeah, this was
coming.
Really
we have to come back when the project drops and we can talk about things. Then there will be no teasers. We'll actually have
I feel like
references and everything.
Yeah.
I feel like I want to just be spilling the beans, but
okay.
Yeah.
No, we get it. We understand.
No, we absolutely don't want you coming here. And then you're getting a call from the management that came to delete that episode. But so what would you say people can look forward to? So can you tell us if it's like an EP, is it an album, is it singles for now?
Yes, I can. I've got a string of singles.
Okay.
That will lead to
bigger project.
And yeah, I mean, you can expect to hear me on the radio, see me on your TV, see me live.
Yeah.
I'm literally active. Hiatus finished. Hiatus is finished.
She said I'm out here.
I'm outside, y'all. Love that. So yeah, link me, baby.
That's good. And you got some festivals as well you're doing this summer?
I have. Like I said, that's home for me. So yeah, you can catch me at the Fezzies. I'm doing some over here. I'm doing some abroad.
Lovely.
So yeah, wherever you're at. Link me.
That's good. And can you let them know your socials, where they can follow you, all this stuff?
At Nadia Rose Music. Literally everywhere. That's the handle. Or just type in Nadia Rose. Google me, baby.
Google me. Okay, period. But no, honestly, thank you so much.
This was so fun. I feel like it was like a nice, girly chat.
It was. Yeah, it was. And we love it. We absolutely love it.
See, chill.
You're definitely my favourite.
Is that because of Drake though?
No.
Okay, all right.
See, this is why I like you. Because I want to know why.
No, honestly, I feel like we really had a lot of fun today.
No, we really did. So, we really did. It was fun. We definitely want to have you back when the project is out.
Yeah.
And then we can talk about all that as well. Yeah. The inspiration behind it. Yeah.
And talk about love.
Yes. We want to get into
love.
We're going to talk about that.
Yes. I actually just celebrated my 2-year anniversary.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Commitment.
Oh, that's so lovely.
Love it. It must be nice for you.
Yeah.
She said it is.
It is. It is.
I love it.
It is. Because yeah, in my past I've not been able to make it 2 years proper seriously. Yeah. So yeah, this was nice.
Are you how do you juggle like being obviously with your job, you kind of have to be out there.
Yeah.
Because you know, when your music starts dropping and stuff, when you get back into the flow of things, you can't really stay away from social media. So how do you navigate like your private life with social media?
It's tricky. I'm still trying to find the balance. The correct balance. Because sometimes I'm putting things out there and people are like, why? Is like, you know, and yeah, I'm finding a balance. I think I like to be open to a degree, but not skin out.
Not in my business.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah. So you know what's good.
Yeah.
But you don't have to see every single moment about what's good. So yeah, I feel like that's a nice balance.
I love that. I think that's a good balance. I think that's a good balance already.
Yeah.
I feel like close friends and private stores must be the best thing to happen to people who are out there. Must be the best thing.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on in private stores. Yeah. Private stores.
I love it.
Not mine though.
Guys, oh, definitely. I'm a viewer. No, not much goes on in mine. If anything, I probably just like
my life is boring as hell.
I show my friends and be like, "Look at this idiot." But outside of that, I'm not. Yeah, I'm not really. There's not much going on there.
Yeah, no,
it's true. And some of these artists, sometimes they'll be pressing the wrong one. Meant to be close, or so they say.
Yeah,
this is my close friends.
Yeah,
sure,
it was, babes.
Was it really?
Was it really?
Yeah.
But guys. So if you're listening to audio, this episode. It's also out on YouTube. You guys know, you guys have been dying for some visuals.
Visuals, yeah.
There you go. On our ass.
Take it.
But we've got it with the best person we could. So, of course, definitely watch that. Let us know what you think of the episode. Follow Nadia, of course.
Yeah.
Follow us at No Shade Podcast. No, No Shade Pod on Instagram and Twitter. Leave us nice 5-star reviews on Apple Music.
Yep.
And Spotify. You can find me at My Own Royalty.
And you can find me at @Aubrey_ on Instagram and Twitter.
Yeah, and guys, we're signing out.
Bye.
Later.
Bye.
Bye.